Oh, folks at home, that was quite a long journey, wasn't it? But we are finally here. Today we are here in Lindenwold. It is November 17th, 2015. Whew, beautiful little place, calm. This place is located in Lindenwold, New Jersey, and this is where we gotta do our mystery tackle box slam for the panfish box today. As you guys can see, there is some activity here on top of the water. The lily pads are kind of dying out right now, so it is good conditions here. I hope I can catch some fish. Water temperature should be in 45 to 50 degrees. Clear water. Well, enough talking. Let's get to the fishing. All right, fellas, let's get the unboxing started for the mystery tackle box, right? We gotta do the unboxing before the slam. We pretty much gotta do our unboxing in the middle of the woods, all right? I didn't really prepare a platform here to film or anywhere to film, so we're doing it in the middle of the woods, okay? And as you guys can see here, I will give you a quick view, right? There we go, right? And the lake is pretty much right here, right next to us, right? So yeah, this is pretty much where we're going to do the unboxing, okay? Let me take this stuff out here. So as always, this month I have received two mystery tackle boxes in my house, right? I usually get two boxes and I never know which one is which one. So I will have to risk it. I will risk opening this one because that one looks like there's some kind of big jerk bait inside, okay? So I think this is my panfish box. I could be right, I could be wrong, I don't know. So let me get my pair of scissors here. We can get the unboxing started. Yeah, got it. Open up here, man. Opening these boxes is always tough, you know. All right, there we go. Let's see if this is the panfish box or not. There we go. Yeah, very organized. Okay, let's see what is inside here. Okay, this is definitely the panfish box. All right, fellas, definitely the panfish box. I got here the paper. Let's go through every one of them now. If there's anything you guys don't understand, I will leave all the names and the prices in the description of the video so you guys, you know, don't have to worry about that, okay? Let me put everything out of the pack first. So, there we go. Let me see. Okay, you know what? I just gotta do it one by one. Let's try to make this as quick as possible because I am pretty much ready to fish. First one that came in the box here is this Slab Daddy Super Rig by Mr. Crappie by Wally Marshall, alright, value of $6.25. Let me get it out of this box here. Very interesting. Double rig right here, okay. Interesting colors as well. A little bit of a purple, right, with a little jig. Says it is good for crappie. Well, I tell you what, this pond has actually a good crappie population, so we're gonna check this out today. Second one here, Maybug Bait Jar by Lunkerhunt. Okay, we got here the Lunkerhunt. Okay, it says here, incredibly durable, scented. Okay, and it is pretty much a little insect. I like that. You know, if we have any type of jig heads here, I'll make sure to put it on the jig and try for some fish, you know. It goes for a value of $5.99, okay. Third one for today is a number 6 spoon by Len Thompson. This is gonna be a tough one for today, but I know that this pond also has a small population of chain pickerel and largemouth bass, so you never know, right? Here, the Len Thompson, okay, number 6 spoon, has a very interesting pattern on it. I don't know if you guys can see it or not. Double colored, right? Symmetrical. We will try that out. This goes for $3.99. Then we got a pre-rigged gill catcher by Venom Lures, okay, and the value of $3.99. Very interesting package right here, as you guys can see, and I like the name actually, you know, it's called Venom Lures, all right, Death Grip. Very, very interesting. It looks like some kind of a grub with a little bit tail there, right? Very cool. We're definitely gonna use this, and I like the fact that this came already with the jig head. 164 ounce of jig, right? That's the one I usually use, just a different brand, so we're gonna try that out. Of course, there's a pack of Crappie Tube by Big Bite Baits, okay, value of $1.99. here you go. These tubes are actually awesome for crappie. I have used them before, not from this branch, but I'm pretty sure they are going to work. Hopefully we will land some fish with them, you know. I'm expecting to catch some good stuff from here. And finally, the last one for the day is a beetle critter by Johnson on the value of 180, okay? So there we go. Let me find this here. Where's my beetle thing? Oh, right here. Beetle critter. All right, look, there's the little panfish and the crappie at the end. Very cool stuff, yeah? Thankfully, I got a lot of jig heads in my bag. You know, this seems like a good collection of baits. All right, let me get everything together for you guys to take a look here. Right, nice little collection of baits. Yeah, so we're gonna try to catch some fish on this stuff today, all right? Let me get my stuff ready. Let's go fishing. All right, fellas, I gotta start the Mr. Tackle Box Slam now. The first bait that I'm going to use for today, and let me show you guys, is a weighted float. This is mine, this didn't come inside the Mr. Tackle Box, but I pretty much need this weighted float. It's a Colmar weighted float to cast out there and get more, you know, ground. What I'm using as bait to start is the 164 ounce jig head that came with the Venom lures, but I removed the grub for now. I decided to try the little, what did they call it? The Maybug? Yeah, from the other branch. So, you know, I did this combination here, and we will see if I can catch any fish. All right, let's go, let's do it. Fish on. First fish of the day, fellas. First fish of the day. Oh yeah, fish on. Nice one, nice one. Woo! Oh, I lost, it was a chain pickerel. Woo, man. It was a chain pickerel, folks. Wow, man. Does that count? Does that count, the lost fish? I don't know if that counts for the MTB. So as you guys saw, I was using a float, right? I had a weighted float on with a little Venom Death Grip jig head, the 164 ounce. But I removed the little grub and I put on the Lunkerhunt Maybug, right? Because, you know, this the only jig head that Mr. Tackle Box gave me this month was from the Venom Death Grip, right? So yeah, this thing here, the Lunkerhunt bait jar, you know, it's working. Man, pickerel, man. Ooh. All right, that was the first fish of the day. I kind of lost it, so you know, I'm gonna try it again. Put another float on, same bait, see if I can catch anything else. I'll keep you guys updated. All right, quick update, fellas. I've been fishing here at Linden Lake in Lindenwold for the past 2 hours, as you guys saw. We started the day really good. We missed one bite from one chain pickerel, but that was it for the day, unfortunately, you know? So let me show you guys, this is a wonderful place to come fishing, you know, take your kids out here. There is a good population of fish. It just happened that I didn't find them today. So let me show you guys here. You know, this is pretty much Linden Lake in Lindenwold, all right? Beautiful place. Good population of crappie, some chain pickerel, some largemouth bass. And as you guys can see, I went pretty much through all the baits inside this little box, you know, and I couldn't get anything to hitch. That chain pickerel was our hope. But anyways, we will have to go with plan B now, you know. I'm not gonna stop you here. You guys thought I would give up? No, I'm not giving up. We will just have to change late, you know. I have a plan B in my pocket. I'm pretty much leaving Linden Lake right now, and I will be heading to this other lake called Kirkwood Lake, which is pretty much right next to the Petco train station. So that's it. We gotta go grab some lunch now. It's pretty much about 3 o'clock, and after that, you know, we gotta go to Kirkwood, see if I can catch any fish over there, you know. And if I can't, that will be it for this MTB Slam. You know, it is a tough day out here. Water temperatures are getting very cold here, you know, in New Jersey and Pennsylvania. All right, fellas, I will keep you updated. All right, fellas, we are back. It's pretty much 4 p.m. right now.
As you guys saw, I started fishing at Linden Lake in Lindenwold, New Jersey, and it was horrible. I got one bite the whole day, the chain pickerel that I lost, you know, I used pretty much all baits in that mystery tackle box, nothing. So right now I'm at Kirkwood Lake here in Lindenwold also. Let me give you guys a view of this place, okay? So there we go, we got here, Kirkwood Lake in Lindenwold. Beautiful place, it's right next to the Petco Transportation Center. So you know, you can pretty much just get off the train and walk here, less than 10 minutes walk. There are a couple stumps over there that I definitely want to hitch. A couple stumps over here, see if there's any black crappie around. The plan for the day will be to hitch this spillway right here. So they have a little spillway, right? I'm hoping there's some fish concentrated right here, even though water is very cold. And then if there's nothing, there's the sacred spot right here at Kirkwood Lake, right, that I'm gonna show you guys. And by the way, there's a video of me fishing this exact same spot. I'm leaving it in the info button above. We call it the pipe, right? I mean, I call it the pipe. We will see if there's any fish hanging around this area. All right, enough talking, time to fish. Fish on.
You know, there's gotta be something like some fish here. Just know because the amount of floats that are there. Fish on! Fish on! First one of the day. We got ourselves here a bluegill! Yeah! Finally something decided to come out to play with us, man. A bluegill, Lepomis macrocyrus. All right, man, dude, this fish is very small. Oh, this fish is freezing. But you know what? I'm very happy to see at least one fish today. You know, it's been more than 3 hours without a fish, folks. The only thing that I saw was the shadow of that chain pickerel that we lost. You know, seriously, brutal, brutal. So, you know, very nice that this bluegill decided to come out to play with us. You know, my hand's getting cold because of the bluegill now. Let's release it. Yeah, so our first fish came on the May bug, all right? The Lunker, the one from the Lunker bait jar. Awesome. There we go. All right, man, at least we caught one fish for this MTB slam. I'm not feeling that sad now. And as you guys can see, I'm using the same setup as before. I just downsized my float, all right? It's still a weighted float, just downsize it. A Colmar float with the little 164 ounce jig head that came with the Venom lures, right? And the Maybug. Now I'm gonna change this Maybug, see if I can catch some other fish on different types of lures. All right, I'll keep you guys updated. Fish on. Yeah, little bluegill on the grub. On the Venom lures, little grub. Now you see, this time of the year, this is definitely not grub season, all right, folks? So this fish had to be really hungry to bite on this grub here, you know? But that's a good thing, right? Well, let's look for a different species now. Let's hope we don't catch only bluegills. At least we know now that this grub at least works, right? At the borders, see if there's any hungry fish, you know, trying to get it. Fish on. Woohoo! Second species of the day on the grub. The small microfishing at its best. See that? Micropterus salmoides, yeah, mostly known as the largemouth bass. Never expected to get one this small in this grub. I thought it was another bluegill, but hey man, another species for today, you know, I'll take it. Let me take one photo for my own references, you know. I'm always happy to see new types of fish. That's why it's called multi-species angling, right? All right. All right, come on. Let me take a better photo of this little fella. Okay, good to go. All right, two species for the day at least. We know that this grub from Venom lures works now. It's time to change it, change to something else. See if we can catch more fish. All right. Fish on. Oh, no, 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 no. You're not going anywhere, man. You are my fish on the beetle critter. Oh, yeah. All right, man. Small. But look, look what got this fish here, huh? Yeah, just to tell you guys that I'm not cheating on this stuff. The beetle critter. Yeah, oh, yeah. This is by Johnson. Small, largemouth bass, man. But you know what? When the water temperature is like 40, 45 degrees, all right? And you get, you know, conditions like this, man, even the small ones like this count, all right? So yeah, I'm happy to see a fish that is this small today. Got fish on three lures already. It's about time, you know, to change this thing. All right, let's take a photo for the Instagram. Yeah, photo for the Instagram and then a quick release for this guy. Yeah, do a little Snapchat too. Okay. At least someone decided to show up today. Bye bye, fish. Fellas, quick update. Currently, it's 5 p.m. and it's getting dark already. I can't believe it, you know, but fall and winter, it just gets dark so early. So unfortunately, you know, I gotta go. I don't have time to finish my MTB slam, which is a shame. So, you know, in the end, we were able to catch some fish, right, as you guys saw, on the Maybug bait jar, right? The pre-rigged gill catcher and the beetle critter. And unfortunately, I didn't even try the crappie tube by Big Baits, you know, a Big Bite Baits. The number six spoon, I got it snagged, so I actually lost it. And the Slab Daddy super rig, you know, a super rig, it looked very good actually, but unfortunately, no fish on it. So that's gonna be pretty much it for today, you know. It's a little bit depressing, but on the other hand, with water temperatures on 40, 45, super clear, you know, I was actually quite glad to see that a couple bluegill and a couple small largemouth bass decided to show up, you know, so I am not entirely sad, okay? I'm gonna fool around for a little bit more, but that's pretty much it, you know, gonna call it a day. Tight lines, until next video, fellas.